I can't see this possibly, guys. I've been seeing you cross my mind several times. Maybe I just have a weak conscience, or maybe I have a strong constitution, or maybe it's just the way, other way around. Look, you have just got to hang in there, okay?
Picked up Maggie, and Roger didn't know a thing about it?
Well, what happened was that Mama thought that was part of Roger's surprise,
yeah.
And she convinced Maggie to take off. Nobody knows where she is.
Oh, boy.
Oh.
Well, I hope Roger finds Maggie soon, you know, because I'd like to see what's behind the stuff right here.
Just stop it. Come on, I don't need an excuse to haul off and slap anybody.
Good woman. I'm really looking forward to working on this project.
Yeah?
What's that?
Yeah, sure.
And so here it is. $3, $4.30. And I am never going to play poker with you again, you lady.
Well, I could have cleaned you out. If Jack's mother-in-law didn't throw us out the kitchen.
You know, I bless Mae for it. How much did you get paid for it?
Well, I went easy on him. Just he feel bad about his wife and all.
No.
So.
You want to say hello to Christine?
Maybe later.
John told me you're a doctor of environmental medicine. You must have studied years for that.
A few.
Every day I see something else on TV about toxins poisoning our environment. And you're involved in that. John admires you very much for it.
Your fiance has a highly developed social consciousness himself.
So, Liz, when are we going to see these paintings, huh?
Oh, my mother baked an Irish whiskey trifle. You want some?
No, Patty, my life is dying. You go ahead, though.
Okay.
It's in for me.
All right.
Are you a movie star? Hi, Tina. No. I'm a market research executive at an addict.
So what?
Well, I'm the person who finds out why you eat crunches in the morning instead of Bradley.
Oh, I used to eat donuts. You know, the gloppy one? But the family that I live with now, they don't let me eat it. They make me eat cereal.
But it's pretty good with fruit.
How did you get your head like that?
Honey, this is always a painstaking labor. But this is what I do. After I wash my hair, I condition it with a light olive oil. And then I massage the oil into my scalp, and then I blow dry. Then I take a teeny tiny curling rod, and I mean teeny tiny. And I take a small amount of hair, then wrap it around the curling rod for about, just about 30 seconds. And then I do it again. And then again, and again, and again, and again.
You do all of that?
Mm-hmm.
30 seconds each for each piece?
Mm-hmm.
So say you do 100 pieces.
Mm-hmm.
That's 3,000 seconds. You know that's 50 minutes?
I can do that.
Well, I'll divide 3,000 by 60. What? Tell me about these nails. Does your grandmother make you use quinine?
What?
Quinine? So you won't bite them.
You know, I got used to that stuff.
Oh, girl, these aren't my nails. I mean, not all of them, anyway. You're joking.
Uh-uh. First thing you gotta do is stop biting your nails. I mean, you know, look at that. That's ugly.
Girl, will you quit? My nails look just like this when I was your age.
How old are you?
16? 15. But I look old for my age.
Okay. Now, here's what you do. When you get a job and you've saved your money, then you can treat yourself to a nail salon. Okay? What they do is they take a plastic nail clip and they glue that to the top of your nail. Then they file it down and then they wrap it.
Wrap it?
Mm-hmm. They glue a silk patch or a linen patch on top, and they file it down to the end, and it's real smooth. So smooth, you can't even tell it's not your own nail. You can put nail polish on it, and that's it. Voila.
Wow. I thought I would have to live with nails like this for the rest of my life.
You got to come and taste some of Mae's trifle. I mean, this stuff
Evan,
is amazing.
Evan, we're talking girl talk here. Shut off.
Now, what were you saying?
Well, I don't know. Now, all I have to do is...
find Sam's yacht.
Maybe you take the baby.
I'm not taking anybody at all. Hey, you're not well enough. You're losing a lot of blood. You're not going to slip around outside. Okay? Now, I just want you to stay here where it's nice and it's dry.
Call the Coast Guard.
And I can't align it down.
There's got to be something you can do, dear.
Maggie, I have a karmic responsibility to save you and the saving. Okay, now all I have to do is I have to get Dan's boat, and I'll work it. I mean, it's going to be that difference in using a car. Okay, and then we'll just get in and we'll sail off to Tahiti. Tahiti. I'm only kidding. Okay, Maggie, your responsibility is to stay awake and keep the baby warm. You got that? Stay awake, keep the baby warm. Okay, are you all right? Okay, and in times of trouble, you know what I do? I sing. And a good song to sing would be Old MacDonald Had a Farm. You know, because you could just keep on adding chickens. Okay, Maggie, now I promise you, stay awake, and I'll be back before you get to the tape. Okay? See?
Be careful.